So this is a video for the quiz review 3.2 to 3.4. What are the asymptotes, the equations for asymptotes, of the image of the graph of y equals 1 over x under the translation t x minus 4, y plus 2? Okay, so I always start off with the parent. And I know for that my parent function is y equals 1 over x. And I know the asymptotes for the parent function are x equals 0, y equals 0. So I remember that this graph looks like this, where my asymptotes are this line here, x equals 0, and this line here, where y equals 0. So then I look at my translation rule. And I see that it's going to be x minus 4, y plus 2. So my new asymptotes I'm going to take x and subtract 4, so I get x equals negative 4. And y I'm going to add 2, so 0 plus 2 is 2. So here are the equations for my new asymptotes. Okay, for number 2, it says suppose the point 3, negative 12 lies on the graph of a function h. Find a point on the image of h under the translation. Okay? So I start with 3, negative 12, and I'm going to translate it, and my rule is x plus 7, y plus 5. So my new ordered pair is going to become 10, because 3 plus 7 is 10, and y, I'm going to add 5, so I get negative 7. Suppose the point 2, 8 lies on an even function, even. What other point must be on f of x? Well, when it's even, I have to remember that my x and y, when I reflect it over the y-axis, the x changes, but the y stays the same. So my 2, 8 is going to become negative 2, 8. Now for part B, it says suppose the point 3, 10 lies on an odd function. What other point must be on f of x? Well, odd functions, when I rotate them around the origin, become opposite of x, opposite of y, which means 3, 10 is going to become the opposite of 3, the opposite of 10. Okay, number 4. Is the function f of x equals 5x squared plus x plus 8 an even function, odd function, or neither? Prove your answer algebraically. Okay, let's see if it's even. So I'm going to start off doing the even test, which is, does f of x equal f at negative x? That's my question. So f of x, I have to do the left side, is 5x squared plus x plus 8. F at negative x is going to be 5 times negative x squared plus negative x plus 8, which gives me 5. When I square a negative, it just becomes positive. Plus the negative becomes minus, and I have plus 8. These are not the same, so it's not even. Let's see if it's odd. F at negative x equals negative f of x. All right, let's start with the f at negative x. That's where I'm going to put that negative x. This is what I just did in the even test, but I need to show it again. And when I square negative, it becomes positive. Plus the negative becomes minus. Okay. And now I need to do my negative f of x. So negative in front of the entire function. And when I distribute that negative to all, I get negative 5x squared plus x minus 8. Well, these are definitely, I'm sorry, here and here, these are not the same. So it's not odd. So I just want to clarify what I was looking for. Here, for even, I was comparing this and this, and they were not the same. I guess I shouldn't have put an x. It looks like it's an x, like it's part of the function. But I'm just highlighting there to show you that they are not the same. I shouldn't use an x there. That might be a little bit confusing. And here I was comparing this one and this one, and they are not the same. So it's not even, it's not odd. So not even, not odd. So I have therefore proven that it is neither. Okay, let's go on to number 5. Find an equation for the parent p for the function f of x equals the quantity x minus 8 squared plus 4. Well, whenever I have something squared, that's a quadratic. So my parent function is, I guess they said they wanted me to use p, so my parent p, so p equals x squared. That would be my parent function. Now write a rule for the translation t. Okay, so when I look at this, my translation rule, in the equation it says x minus 8, but x lies in the equation, so the rule is x plus 8. Y tells the truth, so it's y plus 4. I could have also written this using subscript notation, capital T, and then the subscript 8, 4. I don't need to put the positive sign there. If I want to, I can, but it's not necessary. Okay. Right, let's go on to the last one. It's number 6. Number 6 says consider the function given. 1 divided by the quantity x plus 5 minus 3. Give equations for the asymptotes of this graph. Well, the original parent function is 1 divided by x, where the asymptotes would be x equals 0, y equals 0 are the asymptotes. So, my translation rule would be x minus 5, because x lies in the equation, y minus 3. Well, if I apply that translation rule to my asymptotes, I get 0 minus 5, so x equals negative 5, and 0 minus 3, so y equals negative 3. So those are the equations for my asymptotes. Sketch the graph. Okay. I would go over to x equals negative 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I would draw an asymptote. And I would go down to 3, 1, 2, 3, and I would draw another asymptote. And then I know that the parent function, 1 over x, is the graph. It looks like this. So I'm going to go around my new asymptotes and sketch the same graph. Alright, for number 7, it says give an equation for the graph of g. I'm assuming this was supposed to be my parent function, which we know is y equals x squared. And I look at my new function, and I moved over to the right 2, Now the rule always tells the truth, and then down. Well, actually, yes, we are counting by ones here. Now here, this must be negative 5, because if this is negative 2, negative 4, that's negative 6. This must be negative 5, so x minus 5. That's my translation rule. So my equation is going to be y equals x minus 2 squared, because the equation in the equation, x lies, but y tells the truth. So there is my final answer for my equation.